there, welcome back to Books and Tea with Sarah. I'm yours truly. I am drinking water today. It is really hot today and I just can't drink hot tea right now. However, if you have any suggestions on iced tea, I will gladly take those. I'm really looking into getting into making my own iced tea for this summer because it's gonna be super hot. So anyway, today I wanted to do a review on Once and For All by Sarah Dessen. As you probably know, I really was anticipating this book's release this summer. So as usual, I will start off with a spoiler-free review of this book, and then I will move on to a more spoiler discussion about the book. Starting with a short summary about the book, Luna works for her single mother at her wedding planning business. She was raised by her mother by herself, and after seeing how much love fails her mother and a male role model that she has in her life as well, Luna is super cynical about things. This is only enhanced by the fact that they're in the wedding planning business and they see so many perfect weddings turn into terrible marriages. So then, just when Luna's opinion about all of this starts to change because of a very successful and loving relationship that she's in, that relationship ends terribly for her and she ends up swearing off love completely. Enter Ambrose, a really annoying but cute serial dater who starts to work for Luna's mother one summer, and he wants to change Luna's outlook on love. So she bets him that he can't date one person for a long period of time, and he bets Luna that she can't put herself out there and go on several dates. So as I said before, I really enjoyed this book. It was the perfect summer contemporary, just what I needed. There's always a place in my heart for YA romance, no matter how trope-filled it is. I will always love them. So as for the writing, Sarah Dessen really has a way of pulling the reader into her fictional North Carolina towns. She has one town called Lakeview, North Carolina, and then she also has a beach town called Colby, North Carolina, and pretty much all her books take place in one of these two towns. This book actually included both towns, which was kind of cool, but Colby was more of a flashback. It wasn't so much an actual present setting for the book. I have a special place in my heart for North Carolina, so her books always make me really happy to read and to get enveloped into the setting. There were also some really great one-liners in this book that I marked that really spoke to me, and I really appreciated them. There was one thing that bothered me a little bit. There were a couple of instances where the narrator would laugh in her head, I guess. She would say like, ha ha, and it was literally like, ha ha, was spelled out on the page. And I couldn't tell if the narrator was being sarcastic or genuine when this happened. Next, the characters. How do you not love her characters? Especially like even Ambrose, who is portrayed as really annoying and always like in other people's business. I really liked Luna's mother and William, who is like the male role model in her life. I felt like they had a really good supportive relationship with Luna. Even though both of them are really cynical about love and things like that, they were still really supportive of Luna and tried to push her to experience her own romantic life and not to be like them and very cynical. So that was really refreshing. I really liked seeing the supportive parents because sometimes that doesn't always happen, especially in Sarah Dessen books. Quite frequently in Sarah Dessen books, the parents are unobservant of what's going on with the children. They're not in tune with their own children and understanding of what the children are going through. I really liked Luna's character. I found her really easy to relate to. I think this mostly stems from the fact that her serious relationship that she talks about started much the same way as my serious relationship has started. So I was able to relate to the feelings that she had, falling in love really fast. In addition to that, I was also like that person in high school. I wasn't super cynical about romantic relationships, but I was that person in high school who I didn't want to get married. I didn't understand the point of getting married. And because I had the outlook of like, you date someone to marry them, I wasn't really into dating either. So it was really easy for me to relate to Luna. There were several things about her that I found in myself. So finally, the plot. A big part of the plot is kind of secret. That's sort of a style of Sarah Dessen's writing. She has this motivator that she keeps secret until about halfway through the book. So I won't talk about that, but there was the whole plot of the betting that took place between Luna and Ambrose, and I really enjoyed that. I thought it was really cute seeing them so competitive and then pushing each other to get out of their comfort zones. I really enjoyed that. So overall, I laughed, I cried, I love this book. It was really what I wanted in a summer contemporary book, especially from Sarah Dessen. So I definitely recommend this for you, especially if you liked any of her other books. I think you'll really enjoy this one. I gave this book 4.5 out of 5 stars. So now I'm gonna move on to my spoiler discussion. So if you've read the book or you don't mind being spoiled on things that happen in the book, then go ahead and stick around and keep watching. Otherwise, stop the video, go read the book, and then come back and we can discuss some more. So I want to start with talking about what some other people have said about this book. I've seen a few reviews that were kind of negative as far as involving school shootings. I think most of what their concerns stemmed from how the issue was dealt with in this book. They felt like the characters didn't really respond how you would expect them to. It seemed kind of underwhelming is the best way to put it. So I do agree the response was a little bit off. Luna probably would have gone into therapy, there's no doubt. And then Julie wasn't super supportive of Luna's healing process. Jilly really tried to push Luna to get out there, and I felt like she just needed to let Luna heal how she needed to. I will say that these kids are in high school. They're very young. So while anyone would be destroyed by this type of a thing happening to them, I still think that it would be a lot easier for them to move on than someone who's much older. I do understand that I'm not that much older. I'm not that far removed from high school, but I think that myself in high school compared to myself now would have had an easier time. I also thought you kind of had to take into account that Luna and Ethan were in a relationship for 2 months and it was long distance. So the development of their relationship, despite having fallen in love so fast, it didn't really provide for a really deep connection between them that would have required more amount of time for Luna to heal. So I kind of try to put this into my own perspective because my relationship did start off much like Luna's did. When I was reading this book, I kind of was thinking if this sort of thing had happened 2 months into my relationship, I probably would have moved on faster than if it had happened now, 3 years into my relationship. I think that's something that people need to consider, is that it was a very new relationship. It wasn't very serious, despite them having felt like they fell in love very quickly. Moving on from the sad stuff, towards the end of Maya's wedding, when Ambrose and Luna fought, I was a little disappointed in that. It felt really fake. I didn't believe that Luna, realizing that she's so in love with Ambrose and wanting to pursue a relationship with him, once he comes over to talk to her about that, she gets so upset about him bringing up Ethan that she storms out and doesn't want to be in a relationship with him anymore. It just didn't seem real to me, especially because Ambrose was talking about how he was really sorry for being so insensitive about Ethan because he didn't know. After that, however, I really liked how the story progressed, how we fast forward to some time later when Luna is already in an established relationship with Ben and we see the aftermath of the fight in flashbacks. I just really like that kind of an execution. I know it's really common, especially in movies, but that's one of my favorite kinds of post-fight sequences. Also, Ben drove me nuts, almost as much as Jilly did. Because he was just so clingy. And I think that he was supposed to be that way. I think he was supposed to make the reader really frustrated so that the reader wanted Luna to be with Ambrose. But at the same time, such a relationship was established between Luna and Ambrose that the reader shouldn't have had to have been pushed to want Luna to be with Ambrose and not Ben. I feel like no matter how nice Ben was, the reader should have still wanted Luna to be with Ambrose. So it was a little frustrating that I was being forced to like Ambrose over Ben instead of being more wanting to like Ambrose over Ben. So finally the ending, I really enjoyed the ending. It definitely kept me on the edge of my seat. I knew that he wasn't gonna die because it's a good feels contemporary. So you know that the ending isn't gonna be someone dying. But at the same time, I had some doubt. I was like, is he gonna die? He might actually die. I don't know if he's gonna live. So it was really nice to have that element of mystery that took place over 5 pages that I was speed reading trying to see if he lived or not. So I really enjoyed that and appreciated that kind of edginess. So finally, there were a couple of lines that I really enjoyed that I wanted to share with you guys. So the first one is, you can't measure love by time put in, but by the weight of those moments. And then the second one. So for a little bit of context on the second one, it's after a wedding, they took all the flowers off of the centerpieces of the tables and they're just dumping them on the ground outside because there's nothing else they can do with those flowers. And Ambrose took some of those flowers and handed them to one of the bridesmaids that he was taking out for drinks afterwards. So what followed, I picked up one peony and a rose, then thought better and left them where they were. There's a difference between things given and those you simply find. Julie knew it, and I did too. I never expected anything from anyone, which was not the same thing as not wanting ever to be surprised. So I really liked these lines and decided to mark them. They really spoke to me, and I will definitely continue to look back on them. So that's it for my review of this book. If you read this book, I would love to discuss it more with you in the comments, so please leave a comment. Otherwise, thanks for watching, and until my next video, I will talk to you guys in the comments. Bye!